important in regards to the golf swing, both for the setup posture as well as the actual swing. So we see people who are set up in kind of that C posture that we talked about, where the scapulae aren't in great position to be able to work. But the scapula, the shoulder blades need to be active throughout the golf swing as we're actually swinging the club. And particularly with the backswing, when the person comes back with their swing, they need to be able to set the club here on a good plane. And if they're lacking any scapular stability or any sort of motion, that can make it hard to set the club in a proper plane. So what we do is we test first the shoulder range of motion. And so I have the person standing just up nice and tall, and I ask them to bring their arm up and just testing in that 90-90 position, how much rotation do you have? How much shoulder rotation? How much shoulder rotation? And so what we should see is that the person has at least 90 degrees of shoulder external rotation in that 90-90 position. Or a way to kind of eyeball that is that if we have them turn to the side, that their forearm should be in line with their trunk, or ideally even more so, that they have more motion than or greater than 90 degrees of shoulder external rotation. So we first do that in standing, and we say, do you have adequate range of motion, yes or no? Some people are lacking some motion, but a lot of people have pretty good motion in this standing position. Then I'm going to ask them to get into their golf posture. So let's get in your golf posture, and we're going to do that same test. We're going to bring their arm up and ask them to externally rotate. What I should see is that if I'm able to get my forearm in line with my trunk in standing, I should be able to get my forearm in line with my trunk in golf posture, meaning that I'm able to maintain that range of motion regardless of which posture that I'm in, because this is the posture that I really need to be able to use it. We're not doing our golf swing standing upright, we're doing it in a golf posture, in a bent over position. If the person showed me that they had good range of motion in standing, but they lack some motion in golf posture, then the question is why? So we see two reasons or two causes for lack of motion in the golf posture compared to the standing posture. One, if the person tends to get a little rounded through their upper back, they've got some thoracic kyphosis, I simply cannot rotate my arm versus in a good neutral position, I'm able to rotate my arm further. So that just setup posture can definitely affect how much rotation I have at my arm, which again, if I'm here and I try to take the club back and I can only put the arm here, that's gonna affect my club plane, as opposed to here I can set the arm and set the club in a better plane. The other thing is, in this position, in this hip hinge position, because the trunk is forward, the shoulder blades kind of move kind of up and kind of out a little bit. And if the scapular muscles, particularly that lower trap, that middle trap, all those good scapular muscles aren't working as well as they need to, then that shoulder blade kind of rises up, and then again, I can't rotate my arm versus scapular muscles hold the shoulder blade down nice and nice where it needs to be, and now I'm able to rotate my arm. So a lot of times, it's not necessarily due to a lack of motion, it's due to scapular stability in that golf posture, a lack of scapular stability, which is causing deficits at the shoulder in terms of the motion. Again, that's gonna play a big part in how I'm able to set the club on my backswing, or even as I come through on my downswing. Am I able to rotate the arm fully, or am I lacking some of the stability of the shoulder and I start to see some of that chicken wing motion on the downswing, which again is going to set me up for injury potentially at my shoulder or my elbow, and definitely cause some mishits in terms of my golf performance.